What's up internet, I am Manish from rebellionrider.com and today's PL SQL tutorial is going to be about how to declare user defined exception using PRAGMA exception init function in Oracle database. In the last PL SQL tutorial, we learned the way of declaring user defined exception using raise application error procedure. Though this is also a very good way of declaring user defined exception, but there is a problem with this method. Here we cannot name the exception. In PLSQL, we handle all the exceptions which has no name in others exception handler. And that causes confusion, especially when we are working on a project which is huge and have multiple user defined exception. We can easily overcome this problem by using PRAGMA exception init function. So, what is this PRAGMA exception init function? Using the PRAGMA exception init, we can associate an exception name with an Oracle error number. And we can use that name in designing the exception handler for the error. So let's do the example and see how to declare user-defined exception using PRAGMA exception init function in Oracle database. The demonstrative example is going to remain the same as the one which we did in the last tutorial, except for a few minute changes. So let's do it. This time in the declaration section, we have two variables, in which first variable is an exception variable. This exception variable ex underscore age will now serve as the user defined exception and become its name. Second variable is a simple variable with data type number. I also initialized this variable with value 17, which is unlike the previous tutorial where we initialized it by accepting the input value from the user using accept command. If you don't know what I'm talking about, then go ahead and watch the previous tutorial. But for now, let's move ahead. After declaring all the variables in the declaration section, we will have the PRAGMA exception init statement. Here we have the exception init statement. Before explaining it, let me quickly show you its syntax. Here we are. You first write the keyword PRAGMA followed by the function name which is exception underscore init. And then inside the parentheses, you pass two parameters, in which first one is the exception name, which will be the variable name of exception data type. And second is the error number. You can put any number as error number in parameter, but if you want to use PRAGMA exception init in conjunction with raise application error procedure, then you have to make sure that the number is in between -20,000 to -20,999. Now let's take a look at our statement. Here, as the first parameter, I pass the name of our exception variable. And as error number, I passed -20,008, same as in the last tutorial. That completes our declaration section. Now let's go ahead and write the execution section. Here we have the execution section. As you can see, it is pretty much same as the one we coded in the last tutorial. For example, in the beginning, we raised the exception using raise application error procedure. As a parameter of this procedure, I first pass the number which is 20,008. This number should match the one you specified in the PRAGMA exception init function in the declaration section. Though it is not mandatory, but for the sake of consistency and to avoid any confusions, try to match this number with the one you have passed in your exception init function. This way, you can easily find that section of your program which is causing the error in your project. Second parameter is the error string, which will be displayed back to the user along with the error number. Try to make this error string brief yet descriptive so that the normal user can understand what the error is all about. And we put this raise statement inside the if condition. This way, we are making sure that the exception occurs only if the age of the user is below 18. Right after the raise exception statement, we have a simple DBMS output statement. You can put any number of executable statements here, but for the demonstration, I'm good with this single statement. This statement will execute only when the age of the user is 18 or above. Otherwise, the program control will go to the exception handler, which is the next part of this execution section. Have you noticed something different here? No? Not yet? Take another look carefully. Right. Exactly. Though the rest is same, but unlike the last tutorial, today exception handler has a name of exception, which is EX_age. So what does that mean? As soon as compiler gets to know that the age of the user is below 18, it raises the exception. When the exception is raised, the compiler starts looking for a matching exception handler. If the exception does not have any name, the compiler looks for the exception handler with the name others, which is the case in the last tutorial. But if the exception has a name, then the compiler looks for the handler with the matching name. That is exactly the case in today's PLSQL tutorial. We raise an exception with the number -20008. And then map a name EX_age over that number. Thereafter, using that name, we design an exception handler which is printing the error stack on the display screen. Isn't it simple? Let's compile and see what happens. As the user age is 17, which is less than 18, thus we got the error. I will be dropping the link of the blog on the same topic in the description of the video. There, I have explained the advantage of naming an exception and answered the question of why we use exceptioninit function with raise application error procedure and not with raise statement. And what is this pragma keyword all about? Wait, video is not over yet. Before winding up this tutorial, I have a task for you. Here, I hardwired the value of user age, which is 17. Now, you have to write the same example, except your example should take the user age input from the user. The input pop-up box must have a customized message, not the default one. Also, if you want to introduce some other changes in the example, then go ahead and do that. You have to comment your source code in the comment section down below. You can also send the screenshot of the pop-up input box with customized message on my Twitter @RebellionRider. So many of you guys have been asking what equipment and software or devices I use to create these videos. If this video gets 1000 likes, then I will make a video explaining my process of making YouTube videos along with all the devices I use. Thanks for watching this tutorial on how to declare user-defined exception using pragma exception init function in Oracle database. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks, this is Manish from RebellionRider.com.